You've selected velocity profile C, in which the profile looks like this with that sort of concavity. It turns out that you're right, the velocity profile does look like that, and we need a couple of things to justify that. The first is that the shear stress acting on the fluid is greatest at the wall of the toothpick, and it's smallest at the inner wall of the drinking straw. And that's because the shear stress here has to act over a smaller area than the inner wall of the drinking straw. Another relationship that we need is the fact that the shear stress is equal to the dynamic viscosity times the partial derivative of the velocity in the z direction with respect to r. So a large shear stress will tend to have a large value for dvz dr. To draw a velocity profile, I always think it's easiest to draw my axes. I'll put vz on the vertical axis and r on the horizontal axis. And at the outer wall of the toothpick, the velocity vz is some large positive value. So here's the outer wall. This is at r is equal to ri. And at r equal to ro, or the inner wall of the drinking straw, the velocity vz must equal zero at that location. And using the fact that the shear stress on the fluid at the outer surface of the toothpick is a large negative number, the fluid above a differential length away from the toothpick is trying to drag the fluid from right to left. So a large negative shear rate, and that implies a large negative slope at a small value of r. At the inner surface of the drinking straw, the shear stress is smaller, and dvz dr is a smaller negative number. So if I draw a line, here is a large negative slope, the velocity decreases, and here is a smaller negative slope as we reach the inner wall of the drinking straw. Now what we need to do is rearrange this graph such that we want R on the vertical axis, and we want VZ on the horizontal axis. So by rearranging the graph, here's VZ as a function of R,